everyone, ladies, gentlemen, and otaku alike, this is Recall Reviews. Atillio back here again, and today, more Star Wars Battlefront 2. 2005 classic, PC, harder than it is on the PlayStation 2, I think, if I remember. And, well, here it is, Episode 7. Well, without taking up too much more time, let's get right into it. Hey guys, it has been a while since we've recorded for Star Wars Battlefront 2. There's been a lot going on. I just finished editing another episode of Adrenaline, and that's rendering now. So I'm gonna record this, you know, one or two missions, and we'll see how it goes. Now we're gonna be on Hoth, our finest hour. The Rebel outpost has been discovered and will be destroyed. Galactic peace is at hand. So let's rock and roll and have some fun.
No one ever complained about the cold on Hoth. We never felt it. Even though we were blinded by blizzards, we could see the final end of the rebellion in our blaster sights. Was it only a mirage, perhaps? But on that day, on that planet, our blood ran hot with dreams of victory, melting the ice that stood in our way.
You know, I really thought it was cool when we
there
got to
no tomorrow, men.
See Temuera Morrison once and for all. In
you know the orders.
The Obi-Wan series, and just get that little cameo in Obi-Wan.
Next. Focus all efforts on preventing the final transport ship from lifting off. We'll begin by taking over their outlook command post. Move out.
Aiming at these things is terrible. I've been watching the Obi-Wan series, and, like, it has some issues, but I think it's been really good so far. I've been enjoying it. You know, I think they got Obi-Wan maybe a little too cowardly in the beginning, but I like seeing him regaining his confidence. You know, like, that's definitely something that's really cool to see. It's great, you know, seeing him get it back, you know? You know, that whole, you know, he's using the Force again, and becoming more comfortable with his lightsaber. He's becoming less afraid as the series... Oh, goddamn. He's becoming less afraid as the series is going on. And I think that that is a definite bonus. You know, like, it's... And, like, it kills me because there are some
nice work,
fair
man.
Problems in it, but... I'm just enjoying it, you know? Like, I'm just sitting down and enjoying the ride. You know, maybe in the future, me and Stargazer will take a look at the series as a whole and, like... Thank you.
Jesus Christ. Might be fun if Stargazer and I go where to go back and take a look at the series once it's done and kind of look at it with a more critical eye instead of just sitting back and enjoying the show like we are, like right now, honestly. Get in my AT-AT. The AT-AT. Come on, AT-AT. Let's go.
You're in good health. Repairs complete. Now get back out there. Great shooting.
It's the worst where it's literally just a spawn fest. And there's literally just no end. You can't get in the buildings. Man.
Attack on the shield generator. The AT-ATs will take point on the attack. protect them at all costs.
Come on. I wish these things had a little more speed. I'm sure you've already seen plenty of jump cuts here already. I'm just gonna keep firing on this and check this message real quick. From the movie.
The rebel shield generator has been reduced to rubble. Ready the ground troops for the assault on Echo Base. Okay.
Something to restore my vitality. Oh, shit. I don't know why it seems like with this game, the run button is giving me such a hard time.
Grenade! later.
So I gotta
pick my way up there.
Oh, what?
The rebel shields are deactivated. Moving on to capture the back hangar in preparation for our assault on the rebel transport ship.
Choke. So yeah, I just kind of jumped my... Okay. So I just kind of jumped myself back to this point.
That rebel scum. The orbital strike beacon has been placed in the hangar for you. Acquire the beacon and place it under the transport ship. Command will use the coordinates from the beacon to launch a massive attack from above. Failure is not an option.
Get the rebel!
So, I'm hoping that maybe if I'm lucky. I was hoping I'd be able to finish this as Vader, but I guess not. And I'm gonna have to go back and get this shit all over again. Christ, I thought that would be quicker, but that thing is a piece of shit. Isn't this guy doing nothing to help?
I've got your stick.
Yeah, you should be following me and, like, I don't know, helping to do the job. I do forget how easy still you can die as one of the hero characters, honestly. Cause I'm like, you should be able to take way more damage than what you actually do, honestly.
Oh!
really have anything in, like, to say past, this is some old bullshit. Did they bring the beacon back in here? Okay, so no. Okay, so the beacon's actually out here still. Every other time I've died, it's like forced the damn thing back to like the starting point in there. Christ. This is ridiculous. Okay, come on. Give me the jetpack. If I can increase my mobility. Really?
Competence disturbing.
That almost works. You get like no fucking jetpack fuel. God damn it. Just take the regular guy again. Ugh. And it sucks because there's no fucking end to them. And I already have no health.
Yep. Brigade of Imperial troopers, and have cost the Empire its most important battle.
Rebel shields are deactivated. Moving
moving on to capture the back hangar in preparation for our assault on the Rebels' transport ship.
There's just something about the power trip you can go on in this game. Where's that blaster? Oh. I'm like, where's that blaster fire coming from? Gonna destroy the beacon. I need to get there quick. Where's the best point? There's the best point. I need to protect the beacon. Come on. Come on. There we go. Come on. Just need to keep the damn thing safe. Come on. No. No. Don't do this to me. I wouldn't do this to you. Actually, I would. Oh, God damn it. Did we do it? So did we win? Did we finally win? Yes! You don't know how many tries it actually took to do this. Oh my god.
As the rebels fled, the 501st gathered around a burning bunker and let out a cheer that shook the stars. The rebellion was done. The Death Star was being rebuilt bigger than ever. Order had finally returned to the galaxy, in no small part due to the efforts of the fighting men of the 501st.
So is that the end of the campaign? I wonder, because we... Yeah. That was the end of the campaign.
Okay, well, guys, I mean, I guess we beat Battlefront 2. It was a lot shorter than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to go all the way up to, like, Episode 6 on Endor and do some of that. I remember the PlayStation 2 version being a little bit longer of a campaign, but I could be misremembering. So what I might do is pop my old PS2 version in and play through the campaign on that and just kind of, you know, see if it is, and if it is longer, then I'll just, like, tell you guys in a future video. That being said, it was great being able to just do nothing but Star Wars and talk Star Wars for 7 straight episodes of a Let's Play. So much fun. I love that game. It's been so long since I've played it. It felt so good to play it after all these years. I think the PC version is definitely a whole lot harder than the PlayStation 2 version. That being said, the next couple Let's Plays I'm going to do a couple of cheapo horror games. Just stuff that look kind of like clickbait stuff I found on Steam for $5 and less. So I'm going to see how those go and just have fun. The next big Let's Plays I'm going to work on is when it comes out, Insomniac Spider-Man Remastered. Full disclosure, I've played the game dozens of times on PlayStation 4. And I love the game. I love the Miles Morales game. But I've never played the upscaled PS5 versions or the remastered version for Spider-Man. So that's going to be a first time. And I can't wait to, share that with all of you and do a Let's Play of both of those games when they come out. That being said, I do also have the next anime that I will be talking about for my next review. I do have that picked out, and I'm going to make the time to make that review. And I'm planning 5 reviews from now until the end of the year. I want to try and do one a month. I think that that's manageable, and even with my schedule, I should be able to find time. Like, that's my goal. 5 reviews a year and fill up the rest with these auxiliary shows. Which, speaking of which, episode 2 of The Art Show is almost ready to go. You're going to see who episode 2 is about, and I think he's a great artist, and I can't wait to share this with you guys. So, without taking up too much more time than I already have, because this episode's already about an hour long, thank you for watching. Tune in next time. I'm still bad at outros, and I will see you guys later. Tune in next time. Bye.